Okay, it's time to start thinking about TypeScript now. Because we've got the kind of basic frame of our setup laid out here, we probably need to upgrade our TypeScript experience a bit. Because if you notice that if you go into index.tsx, this to-do's loaded stuff here, it's actually not type safe. And what it does is it will just kind of cause us issues later on, which we don't want. So what we're going to do is we're going to, inside create machine, we're going to add a schema property. And schema is the way that you specify to XState and to TypeScript what the shapes of your events should be. And here we can say events, and we're going to say as type, and our types now are going to be the different events which we can receive. So we've got to-dos loaded, and we've also got loading to-dos failed. Now, the proper way to specify this is as a union type like this. So loading to-dos failed. And you can see there that these events, if I just close this screen here, these events, we've got to-dos loaded, loading to-dos failed. It's either going to be this object that's sent or this object that's sent. And these objects can contain different values. So loading or to-dos loaded, we're gonna say to-dos is a list of strings, okay, an array of strings. And loading to do's failed is probably going to communicate an error message here. So the error message is going to be, again, a string. And this means now that when we go into index.tsx, when we send the event, we're probably going to need to add a type. And this now is going to be loading to do's failed or to do's loaded. External, internal platform, you can ignore these. So let's say we send to-dos loaded. We're going to add the to-dos here, and we're going to say to-dos, I don't know, take bins out. And the loading to-dos failed here, instead of just that string there, we're going to add type loading to-dos failed, and the error message is going to be, oh no. And let's now go into our application, and we're going to just refresh and say to-dos loaded. And okay, that seems to have worked, which is good. But we can now, okay, we've got these values here that we're passing along with the events, but what can we actually do with them? Well, inside, if we go into to-dos machine, to-do at machine, we can say when we receive the to-dos, so the to-dos are loaded, we can do something with that. And by doing something in XState, we usually mean one of two things. We either mean an action or a service. We'll get to a service later, but an action is kind of like a fire and forget thing. It's usually like a synchronous operation where you just go, bam, okay, do that thing right now. And an action, we can, let's actually give it a name here. So we can say console log to-dos. And this console log to-dos, we need to implement that somewhere, because otherwise we're just sort of saying that out into the ether. Console log to-dos, what does it mean? Well, console log to-dos, we can make it mean something by passing actions into the second parameter of create machine here. And we can say console log to-dos is a function, and we get context and event inside there, and we're going to, let's say, alert. We're going to lie, actually, we're not going to console log it, we're going to alert json.stringify event. Okay, so console log to-dos, we are alerting the event that's received here. And let's refresh the page and go, what was it, to-dos loaded, bam. To-dos, take bins out, and we've got the entire type that was received. So that's how you do things with actions, really. And now you can see that the event here is typed to to-dos loaded or loading to-dos failed. That's a little bit intriguing, because we know that console log to-dos, like, really, it's only ever going to be caused by to-dos loaded here. And this is like a common problem, or used to be a common problem in XState that we recently fixed, because this console log to-dos, really, it shouldn't have the loading to-dos failed anywhere near it, because that's never called by it. And you can make TypeScript know this by adding TS types is an empty object here and saving the file. So this is if you have the VS Code extension, you get this really powerful feature called typegen, which, and we're gonna look at how to do it without VS Code in a later video. But for now, if you save the file and you get this sort of typegen thing, weirdness happening, you also get a file called typegen here. Now, what you should see is the event is actually type2 todos loaded, which is pretty cool, which means that we can access event.todos there, whereas before we couldn't. So if we refresh the page and we say todos loaded, then take bins out is what gets alerted, because that's actually the thing that we're JSON stringifying here. So to sum up, we added schema.events, adding all of the events as a union type. We added our first action, saying to console log the todos. We used a named action here, so we named the action, then implemented it there. Then we added TS types, which gives us this typegen to make sure all the types line up correctly.